Sagittarius, your 2022 predictions reading is off the charts. There are so many elements to this reading that just make me very excited for the year ahead for you. Sagittarius, you are a good-natured group of people. You're delightful, you're funny, you're generous, you have a wonderful spirit of giving. When I look at this reading, I can see the different ways that that can help and hinder you. The first card is the overview. It says prosperity ahead, new moon in Taurus. That's the second house of earned income and everything that you value. This is a very strong ability to create abundance and prosperity in your life this year. Perhaps that like which you've never known before. The energy that I see in front of me is just, there's a lot of newness. There's a lot of prosperity and abundance in your emotions, in the way you live your life. But when we look at pure nature, we see a young woman who's growing up. She has her body is changing very rapidly, and she is appreciating her unique beauty. And that is something, Sagittarius, that you may need to focus on this year. The peony is all about dignity and honor. It's about being treated really well. It is an ideal that we must recognize that we deserve, to expect others to give it to us. Sometimes, Sagittarius, you guys are so easygoing that you sort of just let things go on autopilot. But this year, we're getting a message that's very important for you, because you will benefit if you pay attention. Just tweaking a little bit some of your easygoing nature, you know, really requiring those who are you're going to have a romantic interest in, really give you the respect and honor that you deserve. We have the tendency to see here that for you, oftentimes, you know, you don't like confrontation, you're good natured, you're fun, and sometimes you just sort of play the fixer, you whitewash everything. You see a white mop here, and the fixer goes around just painting everything white, whitewashing it, and sort of sweeping any problems under the rug. And we're seeing that this year, Spirit is actually requiring of you to take a step back. When we look at armadillo spirit, we see that the message is that this is your year to set healthy boundaries. No whitewashing, you know, just loving yourself really well and allowing only those in your life who have a deep respect and hold you in high regard. Now, look at this, infinite abundance. Abundance is pouring into your life. This is an abundance of everything. And it's an abundance of love, it's an abundance of wealth, and it's an abundance of happiness, it's an abundance of opportunity. It is an exceptional year for you. Once again, 2022 is a year with the number 6 in it, which is a great year for everyone to really prosper, learn, grow, and create stability. This year, you are taking on the energy of the King of Pentacles, Taurus energy. This is how you create abundance. Look at, we have the Taurus new moon. So you're coming into this year like a powerhouse. Well, you've always been a powerhouse, but this year you are really stepping up to the plate and you are engineering your life in just the way that you want it. You're putting yourself out there. We get the 9 of Wands. You have fire in your belly. You're willing to partner in business with a love interest, love partner, with doctors, lawyers, business partners, financial advisors. You are doing the work. So if your doctor says, hey, you know, you need to get yourself in better health, you're doing that. If your financial advisor says, you know, save this much money, put it in this investment, Wise counsel says that you are going to work your tail feathers off to do that, Sagittarius. You are Jupiter. You're ruled by Jupiter. You're ruled by a broad perspective and a wide range and an open mind. And you are really capitalizing on it. We see that you are making an absolute decision about your earnings, about the way you earn money, to let that which does not serve you go. We have judgment card. It is Scorpio. It is the Archangel Raphael protecting your money, protecting your earnings, protecting that which you invest in this year. The judgment card is really you making decisions to let everything superfluous go out of your life. It looks as though in the past and carried into 2022, you have a sense of disappointment about all kinds of investment money, inheritances, a partner's money. You may, for some of you who are married, you may have a partner who lost a job. They may not be able to contribute, funds for buying homes or investing seem to be very lean this year. You feel like you're uniquely affected by this, but you really aren't. We see you not really counting on and in a very smart way, making the right choice to keep your financial windfall, your financial abundance under your own caretaking with the right advice from a fiduciary financial advisor. When we look at your neighborhood, your siblings, contracts, Nine of Cups, eat, drink, be merry. You have so much joy. Your neighbors, you like your neighborhood, you have good friends, you have good community, you have a good group of people around you. That is Pisces energy. It's about celebrating life. So you like your neighborhood. Contracts roll in like crazy this year. You are in the energy of really being able to take advantage, to beat the drum, to move ahead. Leo energy being very, very much out there. You're beating the drum of your own talents and it is paying off. Any kind of advertising you do, publishing, for many of you, you might be, you know, starting a YouTube channel, really beating the drum of your services, what you bring to the table. But it is very, very much, you have great showmanship, you have great ability to educate others, but you are in a powerful fixed energy this year that gives you stability, unlike previous years in the recent past. What we see for you is the Three of Pentacles, collaboration, in your home life, in your legacy, in your family life. Your family is doing really well. You know, if you have children, a wife, whoever your legacy is, be it mother, sibling, you know, anybody who's important to you in your life, your relationships are on point. They're so powerful. They're so good. They're really life-giving. You know, you give, you receive, you are very much in tune with your inner home life, the house that you reside in. This is a neighborhood that you're in, but the home in which you reside, you may be doing some remodeling. That's, you know, when we get the Three of Pentacles, we get projects going on. You may be working from home, but it is a powerhouse. It shows that you are creating a powerhouse in your home in which to operate and live your life large. When we look at your 10th house of career, Knight of Swords, you are a spokesperson. You are out speaking the truth. You're clearing the air. You're really great as a person who can go in and almost, I don't know if you know the TV show Scandal, Olivia Pope, she was known as kind of a cleaner. You go in as a spokesperson and you're really able to open the clouds that make something more easily viewed. So your career is powerful. You know, Gemini energy in your 10th house means that, again, contracts galore, really being able to speak the truth about what you do best and the companies and the people that you work with. In your 5th house of children of your mind, children of your body. The beautiful Queen of Cups, what a great card to have there. What great energy. You are very nurturing. You're very loving. You're enjoying every moment of romance, of, you know, making love, of, you know, enjoying your life, playing with children. If you don't have children, writing a novel, creating something of importance. You could open an animal shelter. We have the Queen of Pentacles. We really see you embodying this nurturing spirit around everything creative. The risks you take will only be for the betterment of love in your life, for the people that you care about most, for the projects you're nurturing and cherishing and nurturing. I think I said nurturing twice. So well, it's okay. So we also have now in the 11th house of your business associations, of the collective, of the world at large, you want to be a part of the solutions. The Six of Swords is you moving into an arena in which you're dropping your anchor, you're creating a professional group of friends, and also just really being there for the friends that you have. Some friend is in need this year, you will come, you will comfort them, you will help them. I have to say you're really a team player this year. It looks like you really enjoy your associations with others. And if you've had any fallouts with a friend, you will heal them in this year. We see for your health and your everyday energy, you know, get up in the morning, your pets, Queen of Pentacles, rock solid. Capricorn energy, you're very dutiful. You show up to work on time. You do everything you need to do. Your health is sturdy. You're very focused on staying healthy. Capricorn energy says that for some of you, you may actually start some sort of health business. You may start an enterprise focused on health, but this really shows me that you have the wherewithal, the stamina, the power and the energy and all of this earth sign energy around you to really live well this year, to take care of everything you need to take care of. You're working hard, but you're taking very good care of your physical body. When we look at our pets, you look like you have pets that are very well taken care of you. You know, if you have a dog, you take it out for a walk. You're just in a very good place physically. Very serious about day-to-day life and keeping your routine very tidy and very focused. In the 12th house that is hidden, we see the Justice card. You are very much intent on being balanced. For some of you, you may have some legal ideas about something that you want to invest in. I see this is sort of like secret plans. I would say to invest in something, possibly real estate, but it will include some sort of legal contract. You may be negotiating behind the scenes. That will only be for a few of you, but it's going to be highly successful. Libra energy. This is a beautiful time and a beautiful year for fire signs and air signs. So any energy around that shows that you're going to manifest all of this abundance. You are locked and loaded and ready to go. And the only upshot here is that you just have to make sure you don't whitewash anything, that, you know, you heal any person that has hurt you or wounded you, in which you've had a falling out. You will be in this healing energy with that person. Let's look and see what the El Goliath deck has in store for you. This is going to be a relationship, a situation, or just an evolutionary message about your development for this year, Sag. So let's take a look and see what the first card is. The Eight of Pentacles. In fact, I'm going to turn this over. We have the Magician card. You are manifesting healing energy. When we look at this is Virgo energy, very much healing your body, your mind, your soul, your spirit, helping others heal. You may be in a healing profession. The Magician card is Gemini, which can be therapy. It's also Virgo, which is day-to-day health habits and so forth. But you have all the tools you need to enter this shaman energy, the energy of the healer. Look at these two cards. They're just magical. So for someone out there, I don't know exactly what you're doing. Some may be going to medical school. Some of you may be, healers. You might be Reiki healers. Some of you are going to, heal quite literally the body, a masseuse, a masseur, sports injuries. But we see you embodying this energy, and within the energy of this manifestation of this healing energy, we see the Page of Cups. You may find love. The Five of Wands, people are going to fight to get your attention, to become a priority. You're going to be highly sought after. The Page of Wands, throwing caution to the winds. You may be a very progressive teacher, healer for younger people. The Page of Wands, throwing caution to the wind, as I said. And the Eight of Pentacles, only giving your time and your effort to those who are serious this year. You have a wonderful sense of humor, but this is a year of manifesting at the deepest level. You have so much happiness and joy coming in, and so much magic that you're creating in your own life by simply knowing exactly what you want and being steadfast and going after it and making sure that respect and that you are not whitewashing or really sliding on anything with any person in your life. You are giving the best. You are requiring the best. You have the Strength card. Leo energy, it's a powerhouse of energy. You are manifesting a life that you've thought about for a very long time. You have the strength. You have the courage. Ten of Coins, abundance. For those of you who are not married, you are going to marry and create a legacy marriage. Virgo energy, somebody who shares your beliefs, your feelings, your ideals, your goals. They're in it with you to win it. The Mother of Wands, your business acumen. Anything you start this year will have a profound success. The Five of Swords, it doesn't matter that you have a lot of competition. It doesn't matter that people might try to undercut you in your effort. The Justice card is there. You have balance. You have hidden protection legally, morally, from a moral standpoint. And the Ace of Swords, you have all the clarity and all the information at your disposal to manifest and to cut through the red tape and move forward. Sagittarius, this is the most joyful reading that I've ever had for you in the 2 years that I've been on YouTube. I'm so grateful for your support. I'm so excited for your future. Cindy, you love from Chicago. Leave a comment. Tell me where you're watching the video from. Let me know throughout the year what's going on with you. And I just can't wait to see and hear the stories of how this unfolds. Wishing you the best year that you've had to date. Loving you so much, Sag. Take care. Bye-bye.